probably heard about the disastrous woulda, coulda, and maybe not shoulda of Superman Lives, the Superman directed by Tim Burton and starring Nicolas Cage as Superman with a really weird suit and a really weird premise. Well, John Schnepp is producing a film that hopes to enlighten us all more on what the hell happened there.
People didn't really understand that what we were doing was not the Superman suit, but we were actually crucifying, not just us. People are like, if this is what Tim was planning, if this is his idea of the Superman suit, thank God the movie didn't get made.
Nicolas Cage wanted to bring this tragic element to it.
I was going to turn that character upside down along with Tim Burton.
That even though the internet didn't exist, the internet was still mad. Like, that's how fucking big it was.
We were just trying to get a translucent soap bubble, Vegas light up, regenerating alien thing that I still don't know what it was we made.
It looks like it will be funded, but if you do want to contribute, maybe reach some stretch goals, we'll put the link below in the description. I'm very curious to know what the hell was everyone thinking when they were making this movie. That's not Superman. What do you mean ballet suit?
It's pajamas. Diaper.
Pajamas.
I love Superman. I'm all about Superman. I think it looks really cool. I want to see this documentary because this is just so weird. And I have to see what the thought behind it was.
Well, we have a modern view of who Superman is and what he stands for and who he should be. And there's always, you know, there's many past versions of the same thing. This was never any of them for at least most the collective consciousness of people who are aware of Superman. I am so confused. And that costume looked like garbage. What was that?
You are not alone in being confused. Everyone was really confused by this. I mean, it's fun to see it because I didn't have to watch it on the big screen. I'm totally cool with retconning things. And I mean, I read comics, so stuff changes all the time. And there's the whole Wonder Woman costume change and all of that. But now that we know it's not happening, obviously we've known it's not happening for a long time, but I kind of want to know what happened. It's so weird.
But that's the thing, is these documentaries about big failed movies are often so much of a better product than that movie would have been. Like Lost in La Mancha, about Terry Gilliam's Don Quixote, like the new Dune documentary, that Dune movie that never happened. And Fitzcarraldo came out, but the documentary about it, Burden of Dreams, is so good.
It confuses me, their take on Superman, because we heard in the trailer this is more about him being an alien than trying to be a human.
Yeah, I'd like someone to explain his hair.
It's not a bad idea for a movie.
No,
it's like a reimagining of Superman.
For a Superman movie, I think, though, because that goes against the core of, you know, who he is and who he is to us and views us.
I mean, I guess it would be interesting to explore that side of him, because we always see the part of him that wants to be human, and just to see like the other side. And I guess that makes him wanting to be human more poignant. Maybe not done this way with the shiny see-through suit, but
the shiny Vegas suit.
Oh,
we're upset with the soap bubble costume, but like that aesthetic has been around. We've gotten giant crystal palaces, and that one movie where Lex Luthor grew an island out of the crystals, and the different.
Oh, did we like that movie?
I'm just saying the different.
No,
it's not way out of left field.
Right,
we've seen that kind of thing before from Krypton.
I think there's just so many things that were out of left field. Like, I think if it was just the suit, you would have had people who didn't like it or did. If it was just his hair, which upsets me.
I think that was just Nicolas Cage.
Yes, it was. No, that had nothing to do with the movie. It just upsets me.
It's just so good.
But I think there were just so many things that were so outrageous that it's kind of hard to put all those in the same movie.
He's an important character. A lot of people are like, he's lame. He's not cool enough.
No, he's Superman.
He's not supposed to be, I guess, cool. At least I feel that way.
Yeah.
And
Batman's cool. Superman's just...
But you remember Tim Burton kind of revolutionized the Batman movie, too. So I just don't
understands. You're not by yourself in this.
I don't understand, but I want to.
See, and you want to.
Make me understand.
Donate so we can learn.
Yeah, so I'm definitely going to watch that.
Yeah, me too.
I'm very confused, and I want some answers.
Send your pennies.
Yes, send your pennies to figure out what the fuck happened there. What do you think happened there? Let us know what you think below in the comments. Will you watch this movie? And be sure to subscribe.